like it's there to choose. Yeah, just forget the wins, it's the best to use. Won't you follow me into the jungle?
Yeah, it was always the goal to try to get a scholarship and be able to do school and hockey, so I could, if hockey didn't work out, I had school to fall back on. And playing junior A in Salmon Arm really helped develop me into the player I am today. The tools that I learned from the coaching staff and just the support I had around the rink and from the fans was unbelievable, and I think it helped a lot to propel me to the next level.
The program that this is, I can speak to how good it is and how much they care for the players and your development and making sure that you're getting to the next step and to the next level, and whatever your goals are, they're going to make sure that you're going to reach it.
I think just the exposure, since 2000 or so, Travis Sajak was before me, like 4 or 5 years. He kind of kickstarted it for me, realizing what the BCHL could do and where you could go. And I think slowly it's grown in BC that you don't just have to go to WHL or go the major junior route. You can take your time developing, you can play till you're 23 and know you're in a spot where they're going to develop you and develop you physically, and then you can try and move on after that.
Honesty, loyalty, integrity, passion, and commitment. We look here in Salmon Arm, hockey is going to last you a certain amount of time, but who you are, the character, who you become lasts you for the rest of your life. So part of our job at Salmon Arm is to make sure all the players are coming in with the right attitude, and then when they leave here, instead of a young man, they're growing into a man and taking on all the challenges that the world has, moving on the NCAA hockey or moving on in life in general. We want the players that come in here that obviously have their name bar in the back of their jersey, not as important as a logo in front, because a logo in front is going to be something that makes you part of a family, which makes you special as a team player. And so when they leave here, our billet families love our players, our community love our players, and more importantly, the kids. We're role models to these kids, and when they leave here, when a kid can wear a jersey of another player, really says a lot to me, and I can always make sure, I always look back and go, those players represented the community of Salmon Arm so well.
Message is going out hard, nobody slides, right? We're getting that puck down deep, we're going to start rattling things around a little bit, see what shakes loose, right?
Well, we're definitely looking for people that value the puck possession game, and we want to be able to play, push the pace, but at the same time value defense. So in my mind, you have to be that 200-foot player that has good skating capability. We want to grow that on our team and play faster, but we also want to play a little bit heavier version of it. I'd say the best analogy would be sort of like Anaheim. There can be a high trust factor. So I think a lot of it revolves around trust and honesty. So just a sort of a straightforward approach. We're going to ask you to work very hard, and we're going to put you in a position to get better, and you're going to get opportunities to play. And that's the biggest thing, I think, that we're going to be committed to you. And I think if you take a look at the way we organize our game plan and games, everybody gets to play. It's a real team format. And so we're hoping that that sells.
Going forward, we want to improve our team speed. We want to improve the way that we can threaten other teams' nets with our speed. So I think the number one thing I look for are guys who really can dictate the pace of the game with their skating and with how they move the puck, how they get up and down the ice. And that's the number one thing for college as well, is having that ability to skate. So when we go out, we look for players, you know, first and foremost, guys that jump off the page with their skating ability, and then start to watch closely how they make plays, you know, what their commitment to defense is, what their commitment to structure is, and obviously if they can create offense or prevent offense if we're looking at defensemen. At the end of the day, we want guys that A, are ready to listen, want to learn, support their teammates, and are active in the community and really want to make use of their time here. So if guys want to come and have fun here, it's a great place to do that and be a part of a team and you know, toss the puck around a little bit, get some exercise, that's great. But there's a lot of other opportunities in life to go do those sort of things, and we want kids who want to come here to use us as a launching pad for their career, and our expectation is that they're going to commit to doing that every day.
Transfer them into our school, make sure their programs fit to their graduation requirements, and then transition them back home when the season's over. And then hopefully set them up for the following year and set them up for their scholarships. Those that are out of school for their first year, maybe an upgrade in a class if needed. Or we get them set up in the local college here, and so they're ready to go for NCAA. We have a tutor system set up where we'll bring hire tutors in to help out with the students, either individually or as a group. We have teachers then that then accommodate each student. We try to work with each student individually because each one has their own program. And hopefully from there, be able to get them through. We've never had issues with students missing classes. Teachers are really understanding of what happens because of the semester system. If they miss that one class in the morning, we can always make it up by coming to that class in the afternoon. It would make it as seamless and easy as possible.
There are rules and regulations towards, like, no smoking, no drinking, no chewing. We teach them to do their own laundry. We teach them to even do some of the cooking, whatever, if they would like to know how to make a dish, to teach them how to make a dish, and then they can cook for the family as well. And this is one of the things I set up with all the billets that come in, as well as the billet parents. I assure them that the child, if he has a problem, he can come and talk to me, as well as the billets. Any problems, I settle them before they carry on into big problems.
They care about not just hockey, they care about you personally and how you're doing, and hockey almost comes second to these people because they want to make you feel welcome in the community and make you feel like part of their family. So it's a great feeling when people actually care about the person you are instead of just the hockey player you are.